Hello everyone, thanks for tuning in. On this post, we are going to be talking about Uniswap, UniUSD. We're going to be talking about my predictions, if I am bearish, bullish, and my measured target based on my predictions. Before I begin today, make sure to read my disclaimer below as I am not a financial advisor. It's not financial advice. I am purely sharing my opinions and speculations, and you should always do your own due diligence before trading or investing in this market as it is extremely risky. Also, if you guys don't have any of the brokerage accounts below with WeBull, Binance US, or Coinbase, you guys can use my referral links if you guys want to sign up. I know WeBull is still giving out a bonus for signing up and making a qualified deposit, and they will give you 2 free stocks, and I will also receive a stock if you successfully sign up. So thanks for supporting me in that sense. If you guys are watching this on TradingView, you guys can follow me. Or if you guys are watching this on YouTube, you guys can subscribe as I'll be coming out with new regular analyses on cryptos on my watch list. Now let's begin. So what is happening with Uniswap? So since this downtrend right here, we have not been able to get on top of the 12-hour, 21 moving average for the most part. We have had a little bit of a breakout above the blue line, which is the 12-hour moving, 21 moving average for a little bit right here until we broke back down below. So that is not a good sign to me, because when I look at the downtrend right here, I ask myself, what would actually break this downtrend? Well, this downtrend has been being kept below under this blue line, so getting on top of this blue line is a good signal that is a reversal. Okay, it's some kind of confirmation that is a reversal. And now we are seeing that we are trying to get back above the blue line again. Okay, before that, we do see a double top formation right here on the 12-hour chart, which is a bearish formation. Okay, so it looks like that has already broken out. And the measured target of that breakout is at about 2.75. Okay, now this may or may not be reached because it's just theory. Okay, so that may or may not be reached. We are going to be seeing that very shortly. We have broken below the neckline though, which is about 3.2, and let's see if we are able to get back above that neckline. If we are able to get back above that neckline, that also means we are probably able to get back above the 12-hour, 21 moving average as well. So that might be a signal that we could see a reversal, possibly. Okay, that's a little bit of a confirmation. But what is the second level of confirmation that I'm looking for? Now, also look at this. Okay, this is the 6-hour chart. Since the downtrend, we have also not been able to get back above the 6-hour 50 moving average, which is the white line right here. Now the second level of confirmation would be if we can actually get a solid close above the 6-hour 50 moving average, okay? So these are two confirmations I'm looking for in order to flip back bullish again. Now, the other thing I'm also watching for is Bitcoin dominance, because Bitcoin dominance does affect a lot of altcoins, okay? And when Bitcoin dominance is up, trading altcoins is pretty difficult because it will be trading against a downtrend. So I am actually looking for Bitcoin dominance to go down. And according to this chart right here, the 12-hour chart, okay, we do see a head and shoulders pattern on the Bitcoin dominance chart, which is good for altcoins because that means if this pattern plays out, Bitcoin dominance is going down, and there would be smoother altcoin trading action. Now, this is critical right here because Bitcoin dominance price action has been being kept down by this orange line, which is the 200 moving average on 12-hour. If we get a close above this orange line right here, that's a bad signal to me. So that is something I am looking out for. Something that could flip me bullish, of course, is if the price action actually retreats to this white line, which is basically the neckline of the head and shoulders pattern right here. And the measure target of that neckline, which is basically a measurement from the neckline to the top wick, and then you add it back down to the neckline right here, will be about 57.6. So if this pattern plays out, that would give me some signal that I could be starting to see some better altcoin trading action. Now, these are the things I'm looking for in terms of being bearish or bullish. I hope you guys have found this quick video helpful. Please do leave me any feedback, comments, ideas, if you agree, disagree, in the section below. And I'll see you guys next time.